Hello, welcome to Evan Singh Academy. This is another session on quadratic equation. I hope you have completed your homework from the previous lecture and revised it well. In last class, we were started a discussion on finding the roots of quadratic equation by completing squares. Completing squares, and I have given you some ideas how to complete squares. There are two steps what we have discussed. First step was make the coefficient of x square unity. Second step was add and subtract a square of half of coefficient of x. I hope you remember this, right now? So let me discuss today some questions on the basis of this. And today we are doing some more questions on completing the squares. So first question I am going to take on here today, question 1, find the roots of the equation, find the roots of the equation by completing perfect squares. Completing squares of the following questions, right? Since questions are of similar type, so we are going to discuss few questions. First question I am going to take on here today, that is 3x square minus 12x minus 5 is equal to 0. This is first question I am going to take on today. And to solve this question, what to do? First of all, I will take according to a step first. Remember what was the step first? Make the coefficient of x square unity. So, coefficient of x square unity, that is, means I have to take either 3 common or I have to divide by 3 both the sides. So, I can divide both the way. If I would take 3 common, then that will multiply, divide this side, that will be again 0 divided by 3 would be 0. So, I can divide the whole equation by 3. So, what will happen? X square minus 4x 5 by 3 is equal to 0. That will come. So step 1 is completed. Step 1 is already completed. What I did here, that I had taken 3 common or I had divided the whole equation by 3. Both the things are same. And by doing that, coefficient of x square become unity. Got the point? Okay. Now, what to do? The second step, recall the second step. What was the second step? Second step was that add and subtract a square of half of coefficient of x. Add and subtract a square of half of coefficient of x. Will you tell me what is the coefficient of x? That is, yes, minus 4. Half of minus 4 is minus 2. Whole square of minus 2 is 4. So we should add 4 and subtract 4. Coefficient of x is minus 4, half of that, even you will ignore the negative sign, there is no problem. Think like this, coefficient of x is 4 and half of that 4 is 2 and square of that 2 would be 4. So we need to add 4 and subtract 4 in this equation. So 4x plus 4 subtract 4 minus 5 by 3 is equal to 0. Now, this will come, that can be expressed like x square minus 2 into x into 2. 4x can be distributed like this, 2 into 2, 4x plus 2 square. And that can be written as 4, 3, 12 minus 5, because both will come this side and it will be positive, divided by 3. 4 plus 5 by 3, that is 4, 3, 12, 12 plus 5. Because if I would take negative common, it would be positive. So think about that. 4, 3 is 12 plus 5, 17 by 3. Now that can be written as x minus 2 whole square. Why? Because a square minus 2ab plus b square x minus 2 whole square is equal to 17 by 3. X minus 2 is equal to, if I would remove the square from this side, what will happen? Plus minus sign root 17 by 3. Because if you remove the square signs, then outside, the other side would be plus minus sign. And what will be that? Under root of this, the square root of this. That is 17 by 3. Now x will come 2 plus minus root 17 by 3. So there are two answers. Solutions are, what is that? 2 plus root 17 by 3. And another answer is 2 minus root 17 by 3. And that would be the answer of this question. Right? So this type, we can solve it. Now, let me consider another question. Second question is, let us see second question. That is 4x square minus x plus 5 is equal to 0. To solve this type of question, what to do? What can I do for? If I took common 4 from this side, what will happen? If I would have taken 4 common from this, then taking common 4 or dividing by 4 is the same thing. So I can do that. X square minus 1 by 4x plus 5 by 4 is equal to 0. That may come. Now, if I can write this, add and subtract a square of half of coefficient of x. What is half of 1 by 4? If someone asks, what is half of 1 by 4? Half of 1 by 4 is 1 by 8. How? Half of 1 by 4. That is 1 by 8. So we need to add square of half means half is 1 by 8. So square of 1 by 8, add and subtract. We need to add and subtract a square of 1 by 8. And we need to subtract this 1 by 8 square as well, plus 5 by 4 is equal to 0. We had dealt this, that this term can be split in form of 2ab. Remember this, 2ab. So, no need to do it always. Step by step, you will be intelligent and you will be able to understand this, that this is x square a square minus 2ab. This is already distributed. No need to write it separately. But although since this is a beginning, so I can distribute it. 2 into x into 1 by 8. Can I write like this? Yes, I can write like this. 2 into 8, 1 by 4, and 1 by 4x it will remain. So this is a square minus 2ab plus b square. And this is 1 by 8 square minus 5 by 4. That can be written. So here, of course, what will come? Is it positive or negative? 1 by 8 is very small quantity. It is lesser than 1. So simply, one can analyze that will be negative term. This will be negative term. It means here x minus 1 by 8 whole square will be equal to 1 by 64 minus 5 by 4. So it will be 64, and this is 1 minus 80, that is 80, 1 minus 80 is minus 79 by 64. So x minus 1 by 8 whole square is equal to this, right? So x cannot have real value because the square of any number cannot be negative. And therefore, no real roots are possible. No real roots are possible. Right? We can write it, no real roots are possible. No real roots are possible because the square of any number cannot be negative. So it is suggested that whenever you have to find this, it will be better to calculate d first. And if you calculate, this is the alternate method, if you calculate d first and you will find here d is b square minus 4ac. What is b here? A is 4, B is minus 1, and C is 5. If I would write B square minus 1 whole square minus 4 into 4 into 5. This is 1 minus 80, which is minus 79. That is less than 0 and therefore no real roots. So it is suggested that you people first find D, and if D is less than 0, then you can directly say that since D is less than 0 and therefore no real roots are possible, no need to do that. But even though if teacher suggests you that you have to just proceed from completing the perfect square, then for that, in that case, some teachers have maybe reservations that because it has been written that by completing the squares you have to solve this question. In that case, what to do? You can do from this side, and if something square it comes negative, then in that case you write that because a square of any real number cannot be negative and therefore no real roots are possible. But the better idea is that you will find this D, and if D is less than 0, then you can say no real roots are possible. Okay, let me write the third question of this category. Okay. This is question like 2x square minus 7x. 2x square minus 7x plus 6 is equal to 0. Right? So this is the question. Now again I can write here. What I can write here? I can do the same thing. We can divide by 2 throughout this. 7 by 2x plus 6 by 2 is 3 is equal to 0. Again I can write here x square, the second step, half of the coefficient of x, that is 7 by 4. So 7 by 4 square I need to add it, and 7 by 4 I have to subtract, right? So I can subtract 7 by 4 as well, plus 6 is equal to 0. This is x minus 7 by 4 whole square, and that will come 49. 7 square is 49 and 4 square is 16. Again, and this 6 would be minus, right? Minus. So what will happen? Is it real value? This is also, this is slightly more than 3. This is more than, this is 6. So slightly more than 3 minus 6 cannot be a positive value. It will also less than 0 and therefore no real roots are possible. So always you can do that, because most of the students are failing to find the roots in that way, and there will be difficulty. Roots are not real. I hope you got it and you will be able to solve it. One more question quickly. Let me write here. That is x square plus 7x plus 12 is equal to 0. X square. What is the difference between these two questions? Will you say? X square minus 7x plus 12. What is that and what is the problem behind this? If I have divided by 2, then things are changed. If I have not divided, here also looks it 7x, and here the product of these two is also 12, and middle term was 7. Here the product of these two is also 12, but the scenario has been changed. What is that? I can write here, because already the coefficient of x square is unity, so no need to make it. First step has been already completed. Now you need to do the second step. What is that second step? That I can write here, x square minus 7x and 7x, so half of the coefficient of 7, that is 7 by 2 whole square I can add, and 7 by 2 whole square I can subtract, plus 12 is equal to 0. The same thing will happen. X minus 7 by 2 will change whole square, and this will come 7 by 2 whole square minus 12. Again it will be less than 0, because 7 by 2, right? 7 by 2 is, what is that? 49 by 4 minus 12, and 49 by 4 is slightly more than 12. So here real roots are possible. 49 minus 48 by 4, that is 1 by 4. So x minus 7 by 2 whole square is 1 by 4. Now I can write x minus 7 by 2 Square, if I remove the squares from this side, this will be a square root, and plus minus square root of 1 by 4 is 1 by 2. A square root of 1 is 1, a square root of 4 is 2. So that will come x is equal to 7 by 2 plus minus 1 by 2. Now once I can take x is equal to 7 by 2 plus 1 by 2, will you tell me what will be the value? 7 by 2 plus 1 by 2, that is nothing else but 8 by 2. 8 by 2 is 4. So x is equal to 4. In second case, if I would take negative sign in between, 7 by 2 minus 1 by 2, that is 6 by 2. And 6 by 2 is nothing else but 3. So 4 and 3 are the answer of this question. So this type of questions where one can say, by completing the square, you have to calculate the value of x, that is the roots, that is also called the zeros of the equation. So you can calculate like this. I hope you got it, you understand it well, and you will be able to solve such type of questions. Okay, so let me discuss some other type of questions. So, some more questions where, how can you find the equations by solving it, and some other method also involved to find the equations. The second method is by splitting the middle terms, quadratic equation which can be solved by completing the middle, splitting the middle terms. That is also, that is called method of factorization. So question can be solved by using this also. Let me discuss few questions in which we can solve questions by splitting the middle terms. Right? So here question says, type 2. Solving the questions, solving the equations by method of factorization. Method of factorization. Right? This is the way. I will give this basic idea about how to deal with, how to find, how to resolve factors, and how to find it. First of all, if any equation is given, suppose ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0 is given. So to solve such questions by method of factorization, there is a method. What is that? Multiply the a and c, coefficient of a and c are should be multiplied together. Multiplication of a and c, I should write here, multiplication of a and c, that is a and c, c is constant and a is there, c is there. We need to write multiplication of a, c. And split B in two segments. Here one part is this side, another part is this side. Two pairs such that their product will be equal to product of A and C. Means, let me write in steps so that you can revise it and you can write it in your mind as well, and you will memorize it. What to do? So a step I should write here, what to do. What are the steps? Step 1. Right? Find, write the equations. First of all, you should write the equation in general form. In general form. Write the equation in general form. First of all, you should write the equation in general form. What is that general form? General form is ax square plus bx plus c, if it is not given like. Suppose if it is written like 3x square plus 5x is equal to 7, then you need to write it 3x square plus 5x minus 7, like that. So first step is that you should write in general form. Means all the things can be written one side, another side will be only 0. So this should you do that first. First thing is that write the equation in general form. Now, find the product of, second step is, find the product AC. That is, product of coefficient of x square and constant term. If you find this, now there will be two cases. Case first. Now third step, we have to break B, that is middle term, in such a way that its product is equal to AC, right? There are two cases. If coefficient of x, that is coefficient of B is negative, and coefficient of AC is positive, then part of B are negative. That is smaller than B numerically. With sign it will be greater than, but otherwise it will be numerically smaller than. Second, if coefficient of x is positive, then and coefficient of AC is positive, then both the parts of B are also positive, right? This is also positive. Got the point? Means if coefficient of B is positive, then both parts are also positive. If AC is positive. So much about this depend upon the product of AC, whether AC is positive or AC is negative. If the product of these two is positive, and depending upon here, I can make a table so that you can memorize it easily. Product AC is positive and B is also positive. So both the factors, sign of both terms are first term and second term, two factors. So if AC is positive, then B is positive also. It means the product of two terms will be positive. So both are positive in that case, right? If product of AC is negative and this was positive, right? So bigger part, that one is called, one of them is bigger part, this is a smaller part. If the product AC is negative and B is positive, so the bigger part is positive and the smaller part is negative. This is bigger one, big part, and this is a smaller part. right? So bigger part would be positive, a smaller part is negative. If the product of this is negative and sign of B is negative, then a bigger part would be negative and a smaller part is positive. If the sign of this is positive and this is also negative, then both the parts are negative. So that negative negative would be positive. So this is a structure. If you put all this in mind, definitely you will be able to analyze the questions. What are the theory I have written? That is also completing this. That is also covering this. These are the four situations when you can analyze and you can find the factors. First situation, second situation is this, third situation is this, and fourth situation is this. So these are the four situations that can be arranged, and factors can be written accordingly. If the roots are real, if roots are not real, then there is no meaning of finding this. You cannot factorize like that, and definitely there will be a big problem, right? So hopefully you got this, and on the basis of that we will be able to solve some questions. Let me solve one questions just for example, and then some more questions we will discuss on the basis of this in the next lecture. So let me try one questions. So this is a question: find the roots of equation 4x² - 5x + 4 = 0. This is the first type of question: x² - 5x + 4 = 0. Or if this is the first case, if I would take, then that can be written as 5x. So both the things are. Now A is 1, C is 4. So coefficient of AC is 4. The product of these two is 4. Now B is 5. And both the factors of B should be also positive. The first type of questions I am going to consider. So 5 can have, 4 can have. Now how to analyze this? 4 can have factor 4 into 1, or 1 into 4, or 2 into 2. Product is positive. So there are only two situations, either 4 into 1 or 2 into 1, 2 into 2. But their sum must be equal to 5. So 2 plus 2 is 5? No. 4 plus 1 is 5? Yes. So this is the two parts that we have to break. B can have two parts. One part is 4 and second part is 1. So I can write here x² + 4x. One part is 4x, another part is 1x. 4x plus x, that plus 4 is equal to 0. If I would take x common from this, that x will remain, and here 4 will remain. If I would take 1 common, then taking 1 common from anyone will not change at all. And now if I would take x plus 4 common, what is left? X plus 1, that is 0. Product of two linear factors is equal to 0. It is only possible if either one of them of 0, either this 0 or that 0. So x is equal to minus 4 or x is equal to minus 1, and therefore solution said would be, there are two values, minus 4 and minus 1. So two answers may come, and answers can be derived by using this, you know. So this is the first type of, first variety of questions what we have discussed, and I hope you will be able to understand it, right? So let us discuss some few more questions, right? Okay, thank you.